Good evening, everyone. I'm Shawnee Porter.
And I'm Alex Debbia.
And thanks for tuning in to this Thursday's December 1st edition of MCN Live. The Mercer County Community College Jazz Band has been practicing since the beginning of this fall semester in preparations for this year's winter concert. The repertoire for this show consists of varied pieces of work originating from the All-American Duke Ellington to Latin-inspired pieces by Antonio Carlos Jobim, as well as works by Charlie Parker. All semester long, students in the jazz program at West Windsor have been practicing for an hour and a half, 2 days a week, and longer. As they focus on the music selections they will soon showcase, these students play with endearing passion and have a real love for the art of jazz. We caught up with jazz professor James Kelly.
The play. I think beyond even preparing for the show, I think the actual performance moment is the high point for them. But they also enjoy their coursework. They enjoy learning about music theory, about music history. We teach jazz history here. They enjoy it all, but I would say the focal point where they feel most fulfilled is that final culmination in the performance. The jazz band concert is Wednesday night, December 14th.
As Thanksgiving has surely passed all too quickly, following up on the food drives presented by the college, West Windsor's Student Government Association was able to meet their goal of 9 families while feeding 10 who all received $25 redeemable turkey gift certificates. The Upward Bound program at James Kearney campus had a great success of exceeding last year's number of 43 families. This year they helped feed a grand total of 53 needy families. In hopes to snag the best holiday deals, folks all around the country rushed to lines and sat by their computers to reap all the benefits of Black Friday and Cyber Monday. These traditional extravaganzas left patrons to camp out in front of the store like Best Buy, Walmart, and Toys R Us. While some folks were falling asleep from eating too much turkey, others were able to be a part of the 26% increase from $648 million to this year's total, topping at $816 million. Online retailers were also pleased with the outcome, with a whopping 18% increase for online deals at the grand total of $479 million. A welcome back is in order for the students of West Windsor Plainsboro South High School Orchestra. Recently home from a trip to Hawaii, they were invited to showcase their talents for the 70th anniversary of Pearl Harbor. The group performed 7 pieces at the USS Bofin Submarine Museum and Park in Honolulu, being the first non-military band to do so. We caught up with the high school's instructing director, Jean Morrow.
Concerts very seriously, though, and we do some major concerts. We have a really, really huge event. So, and in fact, all the music that we performed was stuff that I had to arrange for this specific group. I normally have winds and percussion. They're doing their own trip. They weren't going with us for Hawaii. So I had to totally rearrange all my music to fit the strings that were going.
Today is World AIDS Day, remembering all the victims who have and continue to suffer from the fatal disease. New HIV/AIDS infection rates are steady in the United States, but the fear of its wrath has decreased tremendously. Since the first case in 1981, 25 million people have died from AIDS. There are currently over 100 million Americans living with HIV/AIDS. Across the globe, 33.4 million people are currently living with the disease as well. Fortunately for the United States, we have the means to treat those suffering, whereas undeveloped countries do not. However, it's a serious matter and cannot be taken lightly. With our fight for awareness, America hopes to remind people to get tested, practice safe sex, and to be a voice for others. An innovative program designed to allow unemployed workers to enroll in on-the-job training for 24-hour weeks called the Back to New Jersey program might sound pleasing to most. Democrats proposed an idea that was approved as positive reconstruction by the Assembly's Labor Committee. Governor Christie, however, has blocked previous attempts by Democrats to establish any such program. Republicans say it proposes the use of money that does not fit into the New Jersey budget. In other New Jersey news, defense attorneys of Daron Raviz and the Tyler Clementi case are asking Judge Glenn Berman to allow them to overview documents found in Clementi's room after the suicide, as well as diminish the charges against Ravi. The defense team implies that Ravi had nothing to do with the Clementi committing suicide and that he was already in demonic state of mind prior to the webcam exposure. The appeals court has set a date for this hearing on December 12th. Coming up next, we'll have what's going on over in the United Kingdom and Mercer 411.
And sunny conditions today, but very windy and also very chilly. What's in store for the weekend? I'll have all those details coming up right after the break, so stay tuned. MCN Live is coming right back.
I can't. My parents say I have to be home right after work.
That's so gay.
Totally gay.
Ugh, that is so Emma and Julia.
Why are you saying that's so Emma and Julia?
Well, you know, when something is dumb or stupid, you say that's so Emma and Julia.
Who says that?
Everyone.
Imagine if who you are were used as an insult. When you say that's so gay, do you realize what you say? Knock it off.
Mass strikes began across the United Kingdom Wednesday, with public sector workers walking off jobs in schools, hospitals, and police stations to protest proposed pension reforms. As of lunchtime, the strike appeared to be having a limited impact on many public services, the government said. Although more than half of the country's schools were closed, impacting many families, the union said up to 2 million public sector workers could go on strike, but early indications suggest the total may be fewer. Dozens of Occupy London protesters showed their support by storming the offices of the mining company, Estrada, in central London, saying the action was in support of all those striking for their pensions for all today. In a statement, they pointed the finger at corporate greed, saying a few are profiting while ordinary workers suffer. Prime Minister David Cameron dismissed the Industrial Act as a damp squib, a fizzled firecracker, as he answered questions in Parliament Wednesday. The MCC Chorus will perform a wide variety of choral music on Tuesday, December 13th at 7:30 p.m. in the Kelsey Theater. The chorus consists of music majors and students from across the campus who enjoy ensemble singing. Coming up now, we're going to turn to Monish Mann for the Entertainment Report.
Chris Humphries has a change of heart after vowing to fight to save his marriage to Kim Kardashian. Rather than agreeing to a divorce, Chris Humphries filed for legal separation to have their marriage annulled, clearing any record of ever being married to the reality star. Kardashian filed for divorce just last month, citing irreconcilable differences just 72 days after their highly publicized lavish wedding. Another Kardashian sister is in the spotlight. Kourtney Kardashian announced she's expecting her second child with Buell Scott Dickens. The 32-year-old reality star is 9 weeks along, telling Us magazine, "You're supposed to wait 12 weeks to tell people, but I feel confident." Country singer Mindy McCready was ordered to return her 5-year-old son after fears the two had gone missing. Concerns came after a caseworker made an unannounced visit to the home of Mindy's father. But the singer's publicist said the child is not missing and no Amber Alert has been issued, adding McCready's number one priority is the safety of her son. The singer's parents have legal custody of the child, although she has visitation rights. McCready has had a public battle with drug addiction and was a participant on the reality show Celebrity Rehab with Dr. Drew. For MCN Live, I'm Onish Mann.
Coming up now, we'll see what's going on in the weather with our beloved Alex Nebbia. It's getting chilly, so tell us what's going on.
Yes, it's getting chilly. Right now, though, let's take a look out west at Las Vegas, Nevada, as we take a look at some video from out there. Yes, it is snowing. It is snowing. It's not time for a new TV for you folks. It is actually snow falling from the ground. Didn't stop that jogger from coming outside, though. They are actually expecting 5 inches plus of snow, and they actually do have a winter storm warning in effect until 7 a.m. tomorrow morning. Take a look at the current conditions for our area. We do have clear skies, no snow in the forecast yet, though. Temperature of 46 degrees, humidity is at 44%. Winds are out of the northwest at 8 miles an hour, and that ocean water temperature is at 54 degrees at this half hour. Take a look at the regional temperatures right now. Pretty much everybody up and down the board is in the upper 40s. Princeton's at 48, Hamilton's at 46, Ewing is at 48 as well, and Allentown is at 47 degrees at this half hour. Take a look at the almanac today. Believe it or not, we actually did reach a high of 54 degrees, mostly sunny skies, morning low of 38. Average temperatures are 53 and 38 for this time of the season. So we are very seasonable today. Didn't really feel like we got up to 54 degrees today. We did have wind gusts up to about 25 mile an hour at times. Take a look at tomorrow's forecast. Will be sunny skies. Will also be very seasonable once again, getting up to 53 degrees. Take a look at tonight's forecast. Will be clear. It will also be very chilly, only getting down to about 34 degrees by the time we hit tomorrow morning. It will be getting down past the freezing mark at 31. Tomorrow's forecast, once again, seasonable, high of 53. Saturday, mostly sunny, only getting up to 50. Sunday, sun and clouds, high of 56. Monday, sun,
two clouds in anticipation of our next storm system, high of 62. And then Tuesday, cloudy, expecting some showers, high of 60 degrees. Take a look at the Beyond the 5-Day forecast Wednesday and Thursday. Wednesday and Thursday both looking mostly sunny. But after that front actually moves out of here on Tuesday, temperatures only getting up into the mid-40s. So it is beginning to look and feel a lot like December.
And that's okay. As long as it's not raining, I can do the colds. Mm-hmm. What's coming up in sports,
well,
Alex?
Well, coming up in sports, I have all your Mercer sports from the past 2 weeks since we weren't here last week. So stay tuned. We'll be right back.
Flip six stairs takes determination. So will getting into college. I've got what it takes. So do you.
And welcome back to MCN Live in sports this evening. Men's basketball getting off to a very slow start this season. Their record is now 1-6 after their recent loss to Raritan last Tuesday. They are playing against Ocean at Ocean tonight at 7 p.m. and their next home game is this Saturday at 2 p.m. The Lady Vikings, on the other hand, are getting off to a slow start as well as their season, as their record is now 0-4, but are hoping to improve their record as they take on Ocean as well tonight at 5 o'clock right before the boys, and Del Tech Stanton this Saturday at noon. That is all actually I have for sports day. There was no Athlete of the Week because of our Thanksgiving break last week, so good luck to both of those teams this weekend.
Yes, we are winding down, right?
Mm-hmm.
Alrighty. Well, it's more than 70 feet tall, and Wednesday night it was all lit up. Yep, the famous Rockefeller Center Christmas tree in New York City. Tens of thousands of specters packed the area, and Mayor Bloomsburg helped flip the switch just before 9 p.m. Eastern.
Beautiful.
What a beautiful sight.
Beautiful.
That's all we have for this evening. Stay safe and have a great evening. I'm Shawnee Porter.
And I'm Alex Nabia. Good night, everybody.